Hello, in this episode of Makerbox Mondays, I'm going to have a look at the carbon fiber nylon from Push Plastics. So let's have a look after the intro. So this filament is from Push Plastics. I'm going to read out the label. The cats want to join in here. This is carbon fiber nylon from Push Plastics. Hot end temperature should be 240 to 265, bed temperature 90 to 100, and speed not listed, but fan off or low. And here they say the it's an abrasive filament. Consider hot and nozzle dry for 2 hours at 70 to 80 C is advised. Ideal layer heat is 60% of nozzle diameter, glue stick or gecko tech for bed adhesion. And I was using my Prusa PI sheet with Magigu PA, and that was giving me good layer adhesion for nylon. And here they say it's a US made nylon filament blended with chopped carbon fiber, stronger than ABS and PLA and more heat resistant than PLA. Manufactured in the USA from 100% virgin resin and then spooled into 750 gram reels in the filament. And the filament is vacuum sealed with desiccant, and the addition of carbon fiber makes it stiffer and more heat and UV resistant. And more information can be found on pushplastics.com. So let's have a look at the print samples. I printed out some break tests and a maker coin, and I ran out of filament. I printed with quite a lot of infill. Normally I don't do that, and so I ran out of filament and was not able to do much printing. This is all I got, but what I found out, layer adhesion was not very nice. I dried out the filament as suggested, and the break tests are just very brittle, and I didn't run it through the break test procedure. This is just breaking at like 2 or 3 kilos of force, so it's very, very brittle. But here on the maker coin, you can see the infill was quite high, but the print surface was really nice. It looks pretty nice and prints really nice. The letters in the back, it's always difficult to show on a black filament, but the looks of it is quite nice. But layer adhesion was not very nice. I could break this apart, and normally I can't do that. So even though I dried it out, I was getting layer adhesion problems. So I don't know if the amount of filament was quite low. Normally I can print out those break tests and several items. Even though I printed with infill on the maker coin, I think I just got a little bit low amount of filament in this sample to test my normal prints. I was curious to know if the layer adhesion was good for this filament, so I decided to print those tests, and I should have maybe just skipped that because it was very little amount of filament and I couldn't print the whole maker coin or sear layers a lot or any other models with the samples. But that's sometimes good to know after the fact. It's difficult to know beforehand maybe, but this will be it for this filament. I would really like to test this filament a bit more with a complete spool at some point to test it in a proper way. I don't think this video will give it any good justice just because I had so little filament to test with, so I won't make a judgment out of it, except I got very poor layer adhesion. That's the main thing here. But this will be it for this filament. Thank you for watching, and if you like what I'm doing here on the channel, please consider subscribing and hit that like button and leave a comment. But for now, I thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.